Hello, I'm Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is a continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. Now, such things are known from the Sikhs. Sikh means a student of spiritual knowledge. But this is we become by the grace of our Father. Nazar. That's why Jesus was called Nazarene. That is, went there to settle in the faraway Galilee village called Nazarene. So here I'm doing Gospel of John 1 verse 35 to 42. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Delivered by Jesus, the first anointed Christ of the Most High Living God Elohim that dwells within us, called Emmanuel. This is the temple of God, and God lives in me. He's not outside. If my heart is clean, if I'm a truthful and no hypocrite. That is why Peter killed two liars, Ananias and Sapphira, because God can't rest in their heart. Only Satan can rest, and he killed them. Because from liars, they become hypocrites. Hypocrites are the one which killed Jesus. They are the Antichrist. And so Peter killed the Antichrist element from the very root. Killed the evil in the bud. So John was standing with two of his disciples. Now the root of the word disciple is discipline. You discipline natural men. We used to be 12 to 16 years old. But first, you know, the parents took them to temple. And when they went to temple, these rabbis, they made them the disciple. They were the blind guide of the blind. But as they grow up and reach the age of 25 to 30, then they realized what they were doing is wrong. The rabbi doesn't know. He's making us Jew outwardly. And he's telling us not to mention our tribal self. As people go to Hajj, over there the mullah tell them, no, you have to not put your surname behind your name. Get rid of the surname. Now, bastard born of the prostitutes, they don't know their father, they don't know their surname. But we know our surname. They tell you, become super bastard fanatic devils. John 8 verse 44. So this is the trend these days. So you have to be careful. So their disciple mean the once born people. And they will go to learn moral laws from a rabbi called the moral teacher. But John the Baptist, he was a prophet Elijah, the last prophet. Luke 16 verse 16. So people, when they were of age, when they were about 25 to 30, when they realized that what the rabbis are doing is wrong, and they are making them view outwardly, super bastard fanatic devils. Then they came to John the Baptist. He taught them the real father, that you are tribal. Jew is a way of life. It's not the physical self. A Jew is one who is inwardly, spiritual self. During Holocaust, not a single Jew died. because the body died. Body was born, body died, which was her Levi tribe, Benjamin tribe, Judah tribe. The people born, the same tribal people die, not different. So John the Baptist, you know, then baptized them in the name of Abraham to remind them that by becoming Jew outwardly, you had become unfaithful to Abraham and to Yahweh. Because you can't have two tribes. This is tribal self. So then they asked them to become Jew spiritually, inwardly, circumcision of the heart, not circumcision of the flesh. Circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. I lived in Ghana for 14 years, and over there I found that the tribal people have marks on their face. Some are full of marks. From distance you can recognize this belong to this tribe, that belong to that tribe. You don't need to ask them. So, to keeping their tribal shame in mind, they won't do anything wrong. They always try to be good. So they're better than the other tribe, better than the other tribe. So they have shame, you know. So that is the base of faith. No shame, no religion, or no dharma. So this circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac only and his seed. Anybody born of the seed of Isaac, that need to be circumcised. But when Jesus came, they were circumcising Gentile who were nothing to do with the Semitic race. And by circumcising, they were making them Jew outwardly. But Jews outwardly, they are tribal people. So they were making them super bastard fanatic devils. So these people, you see them European, Khazar and all that, who are circumcised. They call themselves Jew. Jew is a spiritual self, nothing to do with physical self. A Sikh is a student of spiritual knowledge. He's known by what comes out of his mouth. Same as a Jew, is a way of life. So these people who are Khazars and Europeans, you know, who are white, and they are circumcised. Are they the sons of Isaac? Are they of Semitic race? No way. They are European, they are Aryan race. So, they are bastards. And same, when they enter the fold of Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, then they bring in the kosher, which is they call halal, and also circumcision. So by circumcising them, you know, they have produced fake sons of Abraham, right in the India, Pakistan, all European countries. So Stephen, when he went to the temple, he told them, don't make fake sons of Abraham. Abraham was a noble man, and don't mess around his nobility. You were making them super bastards. They were grinding their teeth and all that for the sake of money, because it was their business. And now, you know, when they killed them in 2023, when atomic war is expected, and these were the staunch enemy of Israel. You can't blame a third person. They created them. So they suffer. Stephen told them not to do it. They killed him. Jesus told them to go on the right path. They killed him. Hypocrite killed him. So there you are. So disciple, as he watched Jesus walk by, he said, behold, the Lamb of God. The two disciples of angel, John the Baptist was an angel. Angel means those who are perfect in the moral laws. So angel John the Baptist heard what he said. and followed Jesus. Jesus turned and saw them following him and said to them, "What are you looking for?" They said to him, "Rabbi," because they knew only Rabbi, you know, at that time. Jesus was not a rabbi, which translated means teacher. "Where are you staying?" He said to them, "Come and you will see." So they went and saw where he was staying, and they stayed with him that day. So when they stayed with him, Jesus preached them the gospel, told them things which surprised them, you know. It was about 4 PM. Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, was one of the 2. So, you know, Peter, he was once born. This Andrew, he was twice born. One of 2 who heard John and followed Jesus. They were of a family, this family of Peter, you know. Remember, there's a story about Peter was, he was trying to catch fish. And whole day he was, you know, in the boat, could not catch a fish. So he was very disappointed. And being disappointed and of the worldly things, Jesus was standing at the, near the sea. He said, "Okay, put your net on the right hand side." Peter said, "Oh, my friend, we have put all the way, we have putting here and there, haphazardly. We could not catch a fish." He said, "Okay, if you say so, I will do it." So he put the net on the right side and he caught a load of fish, which surprised him. He said, "This man has told me he's a holy man. I'm a sinner. I could not catch any." The other thing is the putting the net at the right place is this, that if you have the gospel, you preach gospel in the street to the people, they don't want to know it, because gospel is for 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000. So they don't want to know it. So you will be dejected, you know. "Hey, nobody listened to me." And some people may turn around and say, "This man has gone mad. Let's lock him up. Put him in the silence of a graveyard," as they did to 2 people in Gennesaret, where Jesus went to redeem the 2. And he told them, "Why you go around and throwing pearls before swine? Don't do it. If somebody wants it, he will come to you to ask, then give him. Then your knowledge will be highly appreciated. But you are just going, throwing pearls before swine." That's why he killed 2,000 swine over there. That this is their fate. So don't worry. That's why they became calm down. No more preaching as they used to do it. And they went into their home and were leading a normal life. No demons in their head, as the Jewish people have claimed. You know, Messianic Jew, they are crook. They have twisted the gospel as much as they could. So this is it, you know. So in these days, we don't throw pearls before swine. That's why I made this shirt with no Christ in it, hard, no gospel. Sometimes people are surprised. They come here, "Let's read it." So they read it and they keep quiet. They don't want to discuss it, because it's Englishman, you know. And they think, being white man, we ruled India, and therefore these black people, they have no brains. So why should we ask him anything? we know better, so let them have it. So this is the thing, you know, you have to ask, seek and knock, and you need to be humble. If you are not humble, you won't learn anything. You have to beg him to tell you something. So in the afternoon, Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, was one of the two who heard John and followed Jesus. They were of a family who were honest. While Andrew was twice born, but Simon Peter was once born. And that is why he was nicknamed Peter. Peter means stone or Goyeishi Koppah. You know, stone, if you put it in water, nothing soaks into it. Same way Peter was all the time with Jesus. No gospel went into his head. That's why when Jesus was washing the feet of his laborers or his brethren or his friends, he took them into the marriage chamber, into our father's house. To greet them, he washed their feet with the Pharisee Simon did it. Mary Magdalene did it with the tears of love, not of repentance. She was not a sinner. She was doing that profession because of poverty. When Jesus told him, when so far you are the sons of Abraham, then Yahweh will provide you, as he did whenever they were faithful to Yahweh. These Samaritans, they were faithful to Abraham and to Yahweh. They were having much better crop than these Jewish people, chosen people. So they were jealous of them. However, much more I can tell, no customers. So Goyeishi Koppah, that's why Peter asked Jesus when he was washing his feet, wash my head also so I can think, you know. That means physical body. Jesus said they are already washed because he was doing what the rabbi was telling him to do. That means works. This is works. He was performing good works according to the law of Moses. So he did not need to be washed. Jesus came to fulfill the law, not to break it. And then he was Eucharist, the entering into the bridal chamber. So then Jesus performed the marriage ceremony by breaking the bread. This is my body. Remember when Jesus said, preach to 5,000 people after giving them good food. Unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you have no part in me. They took literal meaning, cutting, eating. They are, no, we are not doing. He's gone mad. They left him. So then he come to his own laborer, ask him, do you want to leave me too? They have gone. You want to go also? They said, no, we stay with you. And they were also puzzled. But slowly Jesus explained to them the mysteries of our Father. What came out of the mouth of Jesus is his flesh. We should hear it by our ears, or with the third eye of logical reasoning, we should digest it in our heart, reflect on our heart. After understanding gospel, next day we preach gospel to the general public with authority in honor of Christ Jesus to glorify our Father. We don't glorify ourselves at all. The psychic, they want their own praises. They want to have a ride big cars and all that on the blood of poor people, as the Pope is doing. Poor people in Ireland, every week they put money for Pope, and he lives lavishly and they live poorly. Even widows might, it is. They have no conscience. So he first found his own brother Simon and told him, "We have found the Messiah. So Andrew must be twice born, because unless you are twice born, you can't know Messiah, which is translated anointed, which is wrong. Messiah, you remember Jesus, when he was in the temple, there were Pharisees, Sadducees sitting there. Then Jesus asked them a question, you know, whose son is Messiah? They said, David. David is flesh. Messiah is a quality, is a spiritual self, title, only given to those who can preach gospel. I am Christ. I'm not a Christian, because this is the temple of God. The royal priest of God is called Christ. So Christians are the people of the book, and that is why it's written here in the Bible, which is translated anointed, wrong. So those Pharisees, Sadducees said, "You are son of David," which is wrong. But Jesus, to tell them what Messiah would stand for, is, "In the beginning was the Word, and Word was God, and Word is Christ." A Word is Messiah. So Jesus told them, "I was before King David, before Abraham, before the creation." Then those stupid people in the temple said, "So you are just 40 years, hardly 35 years old, and how could you be before David?" They could not understand. So that was the knowledge they had in the temple. Then he brought him to Jesus, and Jesus looked at him and said, "You are Simon, the son of John. You will be called Kephas," which is translated Peter, Peter's or stone. Remember, one of the temptations of Satan to Jesus was, if you are hungry, then turn stones, stones mean simple-minded people, simpletons, into bread, as at present these hireling dog-collared people are turning stones and living a lavish lifestyle. They stones, you know, they buy them a house, they buy them a car, everything, you know, make his living comfortable, and they themselves are working like a donkey to earn money, and he is lavishly living there. And what he does, he say prayer, "Our Father in heaven." Our Father is no more in heaven. That was Yahweh who was in heaven, of the Rabbis. Our Father, which is a spirit, is inside me. This is the temple of God. Spirit inside me, and that spirit is represented by his word, is represented by Christ. So Christ is sitting in my heart. Me and my Father are one. Also John the Baptist told the clever psychic temple priests, "Don't you say you have Abraham as your forefather? I can turn stones." Stone means simple-minded people, thick-headed people, into the sons of Abraham. So when John the Baptist was baptizing, only the Jewish men, especially of people of Judah tribe, did, and they were baptized in the name of Abraham, while Jesus was baptized in the name of Yahweh. So our Father God bless you. It's very interesting and very simple, you know, but you need to be twice born of spirit. When you are twice born of spirit, first you start with the letters. You read Bible, read scripts. which are called scriptures, which is milk. So first you eat, drink milk, gulp them, you know, without chewing, without interfering, without learning what the meaning are behind. But when you become sensible and you grow teeth, teeth are for chewing. And when you become twice born, then you grow teeth. Then you can eat the meat. Meat means the hidden meaning of these parables. Then you start looking for those. And that is called eating the flesh of Jesus, because Jesus delivered to us this His word. And in his honor, we always preach gospel. But we all glorify God. Jesus also glorified God, not Himself. So we too glorify God. And unless you have Christ in your heart, you cannot understand Christ Jesus, that He is the Messiah, first anointed Messiah. So I leave it to you.